Hey everyone, welcome back. In this quick video, I'll show you how to install Eclipse Temurin, the free and open source build of OpenJDK on Windows. Whether you're a developer using Java for Minecraft mods, enterprise apps, or Spring Boot, Temurin gives you a secure, production-ready JDK trusted by millions around the world. So without further ado, let's jump straight over to my Windows VM here, and you're going to go to https://adoptium.net. And once that's downloaded, you're going to get this nice new page with two different download buttons. The first big pink button is the really easy, any user, simple mode where you can just hit that and it will give you the MSI built for your system and you can continue from there. But there is also this other downloads option. Other downloads is useful if, for example, you don't want the latest LTS or you don't necessarily want Temurin for your particular distribution or your particular build. So along the top, you'll see we have these different LTS versions, 21, 17, and so forth, with all the different platform combinations. But you can also go into the all versions field, where you can choose non-LTS builds. So for example, you could say Java 15 or 16. From here, you can select any particular operating system, any specific architecture. But for this particular demonstration, we're just gonna go ahead and hit this nice big pink button. So once you've hit the big pink download button, you're going to see in the top right of my screen that the download begins. This takes a couple of minutes, so I'm just going to quickly skip through this and I'll come back once it's complete. Okay, welcome back. So once the download has completed, you're just going to go ahead, open it up, click next, which will prompt you to accept the particular end user license agreement. Once you've done that, you'll be asked if you want to install it for single user or all users. In this case, we'll use all. And then you'll also be asked whether you want to set up Java Home as an environment variable. And for most use cases, you probably do here. Other than that, you'll probably be asked for administrative permissions. When you click Finish, you'll then complete your installation. Now, the final step to this installation is really simple. You're just going to go ahead, open up PowerShell, run Java minus version. And if everything's gone well, you're going to see Java minus version outputting the version that you just installed. And that's it. So you've just learned how to install Eclipse Temurin on your Windows system. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe for more quick tutorials on Java, Eclipse Temurin, and developer tooling. Thanks for watching.